Picture here. Let's just have a look. Can you guys all see my second desktop?
Yeah.
I wanted to look at the essay topic in a bit of detail here. So let's have a look at this first of all. And now the big thing with essay topics, and it's something I think we did a bit last year, those of you that I've taught last year as well, is the most important thing is obviously you need to have your basic knowledge in the exam. You need to know the play and the novel to be able to write an essay. But it's all fine and well you have knowledge, but you can't interpret the question. So the picture of Dorian Gray is in large part a study of friendship. Okay, a great teacher. So obviously this is something that somebody said. I think this is for Nicholas Makeda. Okay, so in large part. Okay, so what does that mean? So largely, most of the play is about friendship. And what do you guys understand from what we're calling a study of friendship? Anyone? What do you gather from that term, study of friendship?
Finding more out about it.
Okay, to a point. Say. Let's go examination, perhaps examination of friendship. Any other synonyms you guys think would be useful? Observation, perhaps. Okay, now straight away, if I look at Dorian Gray, I'm jumping ahead now, in terms of observation, there's a big difference, okay, between Dorian Basil and then Dorian Henry. Okay, because the one relationship gets stronger and stronger and the other breaks down. So straight away, we're seeing very much where the essay wants to go, don't you agree? I'm not sure what you guys have done so far work-wise. Okay, going further. So essay 400 to 450 words, 1.5 to 2 pages. Examine to what extent the above statement is valid. So we need to do what here, guys? So this tells us that the essay, you can either agree or disagree. Now, obviously, if you disagree that the whole novel is an examination of friendship, You probably say it's about 3/4 of that, and then the rest you've got the class, you've got the class distinction, you've got the good versus evil, you know, there are a couple of minor themes. So if you went that route, you'd make it quite hard for yourself. So I'd say you'd probably have to disagree. You'd have to agree with this theme. You'd have to agree. And there's quite a lot of evidence for that argument. Okay. Then going forward, consider specifically the 3 major characters as they relate to each other. Okay. But others may be included. Which other characters would you include? So we've already got Dorian Basil, Dorian Henry. Who else could we include here?
Sybil.
Who's friendship though? I don't think Sybil's relevant here. Come on, who are the other two? Who helps Dorian dispose of Basil's body? Anyone? Who's the name of the young man that we experienced at the end of the play in the opium den? Come on, guys. I'm not giving you these answers. Come on. You must have an idea of these characters.
Alan Campbell, sir.
Yes, there we go. Alan Campbell.
Yeah.
And who's the other young man?
Sybil's brother.
No. He does, in that scene, he does encounter Sybil's brother as he's leaving. The old hag calls him Prince Charming sarcastically as he's leaving the opium den. There's the other guy, young guy, but the guy that Basil asks him about, but he says you destroyed his life. Okay, never mind. We're not going to waste this whole Zoom meeting talking about that. So, do you agree now? So, we need to have our introduction, our body, and our conclusion. So I'm going to take you, I had a look earlier at what's on Schoology. And I think this slideshow, this is in the, it's Lit Essay, How to Do a Presentation. It's in the novel folder. And looking at style here, quite useful. Always present tense, always third person. That's very important. Your introduction, you signpost the topic, you can reword it, make a statement, blah, 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 blah. Show understanding. I think showing understanding is the most important thing. As I said to you, I showed you earlier, I always try and redefine the topic myself. I try to use synonyms and try to determine thereby what they want me to do. So we're examining, in the course of this essay, I will examine the difference in the path of the friendships Dorian has with Henry, Basil, and to a lesser extent, Alan Campbell. Okay, so give yourself those three, because then all of a sudden you've got enough material to work with in the course of the 400 words. So introduction, basically you start off with that, and maybe just load up a couple of quotes to support yourself. Now, a nice resource in that regard is that PowerPoint presentation that we've been working through most of the year, when I put it up on the board before we did the audiobook, and there are key quotes from every chapter in that PowerPoint. So have a look there. Maybe you can find something that's quite nice and meaty to help you with your introduction. Okay. Can you guys see the PowerPoint on your screen at the moment? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, cool. All right. Broad statement, acknowledgements or reference, we've been over that. Okay. Now your body, this pure principle is quite useful. Okay, you make a point, you elaborate, you provide evidence, and you link it to your topic. So obviously that's the pure concept, and maybe something you, even in the exams, just write pill at the top of your page when you're writing your exam, because it's going to help you to avoid storytelling. Because the only way is like you start, a lot of you guys will start off really well, and then you start panicking, you start running out of time, and then you just start telling the story. You give me a little A to Z in the space of a page, the end, and you've lost cognizance, you've lost connection to the topic, so your mark starts falling massively. Because you've got those two, you've got the content and the style and language sort of components. So your style language is fine, but in your content, you start drifting lower and lower and lower on that rubric, and your market's worse and worse. So you must keep relating what you're saying back to the topic, back to your first statement. Okay, so for example, so our point, we talk about Basil. Let's say our point is Basil and Dorian. So the point is that they start off really close, and you can mention they met at that function at some other lady's house, and that Basil found a strong connection with Dorian, and Dorian found a strong connection with him, sort of helping him navigate Victorian society at the time, and Dorian then is now Basil's subject for art. He begins to paint the portrait, and now we can talk about how it goes badly. Okay, Henry comes one afternoon and demands to meet him. Okay, and then Henry starts to introduce him to notions of hedonism, aestheticism, etc. Okay, and then we link back and say, well, look, this friendship is indecent. Okay, what is one sort of like unusual thing that Dorian, I mean, as much as Basil loves Dorian as a friend, what does he say when he describes Dorian to Henry? Can you guys remember? No one remember. He mentions very early on in the first chapter that at times Dorian seems to enjoy hurting his feelings on purpose. So I don't know if we discussed the whole fallen hero concept. I think we did towards the end of the first term. But I said to you, you can decide for yourself whether Dorian becomes evil or if the portrait just unleashes his potential for it. And I think he has the potential all the way through. He is cruel. He's cruel to Basil. So you could, so you're describing that relationship, and you could say, but surprisingly, you know, despite how much Basil admires him and potentially is in love with him, Dorian is still very cruel to him at times. But he's prepared to look past that. I mean, and that you'll find if you care very much about people, the whole pros and cons situation, you will look past their foibles at times to suit yourself. And Basil's prepared to do that initially. He looks past Dorian's flaws because he cares so much about it. Okay, so there's our point. We've elaborated on its evidence. You could say in chapter one, it says that. Or you could say it alludes to in where in the novel. You don't have to, you know, obviously provide page numbers, etc., like you do with poetry. But so you've linked, and you link back to your topic. Then our second paragraph would probably be about the ascent of his friendship with Henry. So he meets Henry initially, and Henry blows his mind with what? What is it? How does Henry speak? What does he use all the time? Jared?
So he uses paradoxes.
Yeah, his paradoxical statements. And he seduces, okay, and I know seduction is often a sexual term, and we can assume in between the lines that there is a sexual aspect to their relationship, but he seduces him with his ideas. Okay? and that relationship, they begin to spend more and more time together. And you, what would be your evidence of the tipping of the scales in those two relationships? What would be your, what would be the evidence? Where did that all go together? Yeah.
To the theatre, Dorian takes the carriage with Lord Henry instead of Basil.
And then Basil follows behind another one. And that to me would be the evidence I would provide, talking about the ascent. It's probably evidence for both. You could say that moment shows the change, the balance shifting. And Dorian also crosses from good to evil in that moment on the way to the theatre to watch Sybil perform. And then if you want to add an additional one, if you've got enough space, if you've got enough time, then you can talk about Alan Campbell and say that it's described in the chapter leading up to it how much time these guys spent together. They were inseparable. And what is their common denominator? What linked them? What do they have in common? Their love of music. Okay. And then we get this, it's a mysterious, I mean, it's started from a third person perspective, and no one seems to understand why these guys started to avoid each other. Now, obviously, Dorian has pulled, and we know by that stage, Dorian is years and years into his experimentation with his portrait, and he's pulled him into something very evil. And Campbell wants nothing to do with him. And how does Dorian get Campbell to help him dispose of Basil's body? How does he do it?
Tells Alan Campbell that he'll basically expose him because Alan Campbell did something bad in the past.
So what term would you use, blanket term would you use to describe that situation? Blackmail. He blackmails him. Yeah. He gives him a letter. He says, I'm going to make this public knowledge. And Campbell very reluctantly goes along and uses his scientific knowledge. I assume he dismembers Basil in terms of the description of the tools, and then either burns or dissolves his body in acid. Okay, so you can mention that as your caveat. How would you conclude the essay, guys? How would you conclude? Okay, let's look at the notes here. You need to show up your arguments. You got to finalize your argument. Maybe save a nice little nugget of information right for the end if you're looking at the examinations of friendships. You could say, what I would probably use if I was on this essay is I would talk about how just before, the night that Dorian murders Basil, is tired of hearing bad things, despite the fact that Dorian has rejected him and pushed him away. He goes to talk to him about his reputation. Like, Basil still cares enough to make it his mission before he's going on an overseas trip. He's on his way to Paris to the station. He goes past Dorian's house and he waits there for 3 hours for him to talk to him about all these horrible things he's hearing about him, because he still cares about him. So you could say that despite all the bad that Dorian does, Basil still cares enough about him to go and expose himself and ends up being murdered for his interest. So poor Basil, it's quite ironic that, I suppose the whole way through, that Basil's interest in this person results in his death, untimely death. So that is how I would conclude it, is that despite everything, Dorian is still adored and loved by people. And you could probably say he doesn't deserve it. He doesn't deserve for people to care about him. And you could probably argue and say that he gets his just desserts in the end. When he destroys the portrait at the end of the novel and he dies, he probably deserves it for how poorly he treated people in his life. And you could probably list there that Dorian treats everyone badly. He had a poor example in his grandfather because his mom died when he was really young, but he's abhorrently cruel to Sybil. He's very, very cruel and murderous towards Basil. He destroys Alan Campbell's life amongst others, or threatens to destroy his life, but like really wrongs him. And the only person he seems to be okay with is Henry. And if you look at their relationship, both of them are quite self-seeking, but Henry's not a good person. You think, why on earth does he even, do anything for him? Okay. I'm waffling a bit now, but I think if you haven't done your essay yet, if you use the PowerPoint, perhaps include a little bit. I'm recording this. I'll WhatsApp it to all of you. Maybe go through this again. But just remember that, introduction. Define the question for yourself, okay, and indicate what angle you're going to take in the course of your essay. Then link. You need to minimize it. It says that a couple of examples. Never use more than three because you don't have enough time. And then in your conclusion, just sum up. Save one little nugget, something quite pertinent and important for your conclusion, and then sew up your loose ends. I like this last line here. End with a confident claim. It can thus be confidently stated that the novel is a criticism of the lack of moral fiber of Victorian society and its pursuit of essential pleasures. I'd say it can thus be confidently stated that the novel is a very accurate examination of friendships during the Victorian times. You could also perhaps include one more point I've just thought of, is because these guys are so wealthy and idle, is that they don't really value friendships, because you just get more. They move in circles with other people who also have wealth.